Okay, good afternoon, dear ladies. Let's bless that we will all have the zchut to greet Mashiach Tzidken Baruch Amin Moim Bimara Bimeinu Amen Eliyahu Navi Eliyahu Tishbi Eliyahu Giladi Bimara Yavon Moshech David Eliyahu Mizachu Latov. And we will all have the zchut to see the building of Beit HaMikdash HaTlishi Bimara Bimeinu Amen Ki Ayin Bayin Rubi Shabbat Netzion Atat Akum Terachem Tzion Ki Et Lachanina Ki Bamoed Hashivenu Adonai Elecha Venashuva Chadesh Yameinu Kekedem. And we will all have the zchut to go to Eretz Yisrael on the wings of Eagle and we'll all have part in Eretz Yisrael. בשם השם נעשה ונצליח, אין עוד מלבדו השם, שפתי תצחק ופי הגיתי לתך. And everything that we are doing is in the זכות of כל ישראל בעזרת השם. Dear ladies, the שיעור is in the זכות of כל ישראל, and בעזרת השם also in the זכות of all of the souls, לילוי נשמת, all of the souls that were murdered viciously, the cops, the soldiers, the citizens that were murdered viciously by the hands of the terrorists. Hashem yikom aleihem shalom tishutam tzara b'tzara chayim. Hashem yikom damam. Hashem will revenge their blood. And I would like to mention the names of the ones that all of the six hostages and all of the three cops. So it's Hirsch, Goldberg, Pauline, Eden Yerushalmi, Ori Denino, Carmel Gat, Alex Lubanov, Almok Sarusi, and the cops that were on the checkpoint in Hebron, Roni Shakuri, Hadas Barnach, Arik Ben Eliyahu, Aleihem Shalom Tinish Matam Tzara B'Tzor Chaim, Hashem Yikom Damam. And I would like to, may Hashem bring all of our hostages now safely. Hashem can do whatever he wants. May we have the zchut that this will happen, Bezrat Hashem, that may we repent and do what Hashem wants us to do, and Hashem, Bezrat Hashem, will bring them safely home. Right now, Bezrat Hashem, and all them and all of their families in Klal Yisrael, and with all the family of humanity, we will all repent and do the will of God like he wants us to do it. And Bezrat Hashem, Hashem will stand on the right side of our soldiers, ויתרם בחטא ישועה, ותרת ניצחון, ויקם בנו כתוב, כי אדוני אלוהיכם, ההולך עמכם, נילחם לכם, עם מועדכם, להושיע אתכם, ונאמר אמן, בעזרת השם. And רפואה שלמה to all of the wounded, to all of the, all mentally and physically. And among them, רפואה שלמה, ליונה בת שרה זוהרה, דבורה בת שרנה, אנג'לה עדינה בת גולצ'רה, אליה בת פרידה, חווה בת חנה, שירלי בת נאווה, שרה בת מלכה, שרה רחל בת חסידה שרה, לאה פרלה בת חנה ברכה, אביגיל בת אסתר ברכה, שרה בת אסתר נחמה, איילת חיה בת גאולה, גיטל בת חווה, ראובן בן זינה, אלו מיכאל בן שירן, הלני אורנה בת חנחנה, ארי שמעון בן מיטל מזל, אברהם בן רחל, בר בן הילה, ירון בן יצחק ביבלונקה, משה אהרון בן רייזל, אלתר פרל בת גיטל, נונו רחל בת תמר, מלכה מדלנה בת שמחה, ג'נט שושנה חיה בת אולגה חיה, שמחה סימה בת שרה, רחמים בן שרה, שאול בן שרה, ניסים בן שרה, גלוריה דבורה בת גלדי שמחה, בעזרת השם רפואה שלמה לאוחנה בן אולגה, מרים בת שינה חנה, חיים אליעזר בן ראיה, משה ארז בן אסתר, שיראל בת איזבל אסתר, גבריאל בן זילפה, יוסף בן שרה, אסתר בת שרה, מזל בת רחל, בלה בת עדינה אנג'לה, מלי מלכה בת מרים, two babies, שרה בת סיוון, מלכה הינדה בת מזל מרים, שמעון יעקב בן טובה, יפה בת טובה, חני חנה בת חווה, חיים אהרון בן שמחה, ויקטור בן שרה, רחל בת דינה, אורית בת שרה, רבקה הילה, הודיה בת רחל, יהודה בן תמרה, עדנה ימיני בת מרגלית, ישי בן מרים, שרה בת רינה, ויולט סגולה בת חנה, אברהם חיים בן שרה מלכה, רבקה אסתר בת נעמי, לינדה לאה בת שרה רחל, רוחמה אסתר בת שרה, רמי בן ויקטוריה, שרה סעידי בת אסתר, שירה אביגיל בת אילנה צביה, שושנה בת מרים, מנדל בן נחמה דינה, רחל בת דינה, לאה בת לאה בת שרה, מזל בת ברטה מרסלה, אמיל בן שרה, רחל פשה בת חנה, בעזרת השם, רפואה, health mentally and physically to Klal Yisrael that we will have the zchut to accept upon ourselves the mitzvah of repenting, and Hashem will help us to do it Bezrat Hashem his way. We always, in everything that we want to do in this world, we have to ask Hashem for help. We just need to do the effort. The soul is from God, it's from Hashem, so we need to show the will that we want to do the effort, and Hashem opens the gates for us. בדרך שאדם רוצה ללך בה, מוליכין אותו בה. The path that the person wants to walk in, Hashem opens the path for him. So בעזרת השם, everything that we do, if it's work, study, income, children, marriages, everything. A person wants to get married, he says, Hashem, I'm ready, please. I want to build a home that will be based on Torah and mitzvot, on Torah and the commandments. Please, Hashem, help me to build a home and have children to teach them your way. You will see. You just make the effort. You ask from Hashem, you go to the Shadchan, the Shadchanit, and Hashem opens the path for a person. But it has to be from the heart, not only blah, blah, blah from our mouth. It has to, that mouth and the heart should be even. So Bezrat Hashem and everybody that is healthy, may Hashem continue the health mentally and physically, and may we all be strong in our will to do the will of Hashem. So everything that we do, we have to ask Hashem, please help us to do this and this. Then Kimalacha v'tzave lach lishmecha b'chol d'checha. Immediately King David says Hashem brings angels to help you and to protect you in all of your ways. So furthermore, Bezrat Hashem, also Metir Asurim to all of the captured, and may Hashem bring them back safely home. And Metir Asurim also to Erbin Avner, Netanel Ben Siona Sonia, Yaakov Ben Malka, Rosette Beret Bat Odet Yehudit, Shoshana Bat Esther, and also Amiram Ben Uliel. And oh, I have a few more for Refuah Shlema, Emuna Anel Bat Tova, Roman Ben Raya, Shoshana Bat Zviya, Lila Bat Zveta, Shalom Ben Zviya, Bezrat Hashem, and Bezrat Hashem Leda Kala, Easy Birth, Tatova Bat Lea Rachel. And everybody that needs Yeshuot, may Hashem help them, and they will have Yeshuot. For Klal Yisrael and the whole world, all humanity should repent and do the will of God. So now, girls, we are continuing with Halachot. You know, it's the second year, we're in the month of Elul. The Sfaradim already started Slichot, Beshah Tova. I don't know if you saw, but I'm going to put it on the WhatsApp. How many Jewish people were in front of the Western Wall doing Slichot, yes, last night. Baruch Hashem, Baruch Hashem, Eno Mikamcha Yisrael. Goy Echad Baaretz, Kol Am Yisrael Tzadikim, Kol Am Yisrael Bnei Melachim, Am Yisrael Chai, David Melech Yisrael Chai Bekayam. It's just heartwarming to see it, Baruch Hashem, standing to say Slichot together, and may Hashem accept our repentance and have mercy upon us. And again, I'm telling you, we are Ikvata de Meshicha. We are the generation, Arizal says, the generation of Mashiach is the generation that went out of Egypt. Remember that we went out of Egypt with Erev Rav. They are still among us and they don't feel any connection to the Jewish people, nothing. Even though they look Israeli, they don't think, they look Jewish, but they are not. So they don't feel any connection. They have mercy upon our enemies, but not mercy upon us. Unbelievable, but this is what it is. And we're waiting for Mashiach. Bezrat Hashem, Moshe Rabbeinu will come with Mashiach ben Yosef and Mashiach ben David. Bimera b'yameinu, amen. So dear ladies, we need to prepare ourselves. Ikon likrat Elokecha Yisrael. We need to prepare ourselves to receive the light of God in this world. So even though we are the heel of all of the image, we are the heel, the lowest part of the body, but the whole body stands on the heel. So we are a very important generation. And HaFetz Chaim, Alav HaShalom Sotot HaGan Aleinu, says that at the end of days, we will see that a lot of evil will come out. And this is because all of the internal part of the world is already fixed. Now it's the external part, and God shows everything. You can see what is good and what is not good. And today, It's unbelievable, but the good is considered not good, and the not good is considered good. Sour is considered sweet, and sweet is considered sour. Darkness is considered light, and light is considered darkness. Just like the prophet says. So hang on with emunah and bitachon, with faith and confidence, in order to hang on, because Hashem is sifting humanity. Mamash, He takes a sift and sifts us in order to hang on to Hashem. Engage in Torah lessons. By this we get the light of Hashem, the energy of Hashem, and we have the strength to overcome all of the challenges that we have. So, dear ladies, Chazak uBaruch. And I'm reminding you that we're learning halachot. V'halacha is Dvar Hashem, is the commandment is the word of Hashem. So if you have any questions and you have and you don't understand the halacha, you should have a rabbi to ask the halacha. Okay, to consult a rabbi, see that you have a rabbi, that you can consult him, and b'siyata d'shmaya, and know what you need to do, because by this we are creating heavenly worlds, even though we don't see it. This is the essence of freedom of choice. Hashem gave us the Torah, okay? We have the Torah, Hashem gave us the Torah, and Hashem tells us, this, I created the world, and I'm giving you the Ten Commandments, I gave you the whole Torah, I gave you the prophets, I gave the Torah, Nevi'im, Ketuvim, and from this you have to learn my way, and follow my way, says Hashem. So Be'ezrat Hashem, we need to listen to Hashem, and by this Hashem says, I'll bestow blessings, endless blessings towards you. Hashem is good, and the essence of good is bestowing good. We are the ones that have the freedom of choice, in order that we will have the merit to go back under the throne of Hashem. So, dear ladies, we are in Kibud Orim. I would like to remind you, Bekibud Orim, respecting thy father and mother, I'm reminding you in Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, the second volume, chapter 143, honoring thy father and mother. And he who honors thy father and mother, Hashem promises a long life for them. So if we want to be written, and we are in front of the Rosh Hashanah, the big judgment day, three books are open: the book of life, the book of death, the book of intermediate. The righteous immediately are written in the book of life. The wicked are immediately written in the book of death. And the ones that the scale, they have even good things and not good things, are still hanging on for the 10 days of atonement. So, dear ladies, we want to be written and sealed in the book of life. Ktiva v'chatima tova. So, you asked me to teach. Hashem sent you to ask me to teach halachot. And I was very afraid to touch this. But, Baruch Hashem, Hashem gave us the zchut to learn, to study together. We are finishing the second year. And Eliyahu the prophet says, he who studies halachot has part in the world to come. So, we study enough halachot to cover the whole week together. So it says two halachot a day. So Baruch Hashem, everything that we study together, it covers the whole week. And v'siyata d'shmaya, may Hashem subscribe us and seal us in the book of life, and may all of us will see happiness, and everybody will have plenty, and we'll be happy for each other. We have a satisfied eye, an eye that is not jealous of what others have, only in order to elevate our soul. Bezrat Hashem, and by this we're doing the will of Hashem. So, dear ladies, now the last thing that we spoke was Chayav Lamod Bifnei Aviv Ubifnei Imo. That's the seven halacha. And also we said Chayav Lechabdam Gam Lachar Moto. So, in the presence of your father and mother, you should stand. And also that after our parents pass away, we have to honor them. And this is by our deeds. If we follow the way of Hashem, we honor them. Otherwise, Hashem calls them back. It's not finished. He calls them in heaven and tells them, look at your children. So if they taught them to go in the way of Hashem, then nothing happens to them. But if they didn't, they also pay for it in heaven. Can you imagine? So in order to honor them, we need to follow the way of Hashem. And by following the way of Hashem, we elevate their soul by saying the Kaddish, by giving tzedakah, charity, everything. We elevate their soul in paradise. Not only we give them nachat, but we also elevate their soul in Gan Eden. And remember, from all of the tzaddikim that we study together, Be'ezrat Hashem, and also Be'ezrat Hashem, that all of the souls that don't have anybody to say Kaddish for them, may they be always, I always say that, maybe may they all, Be'ezrat Hashem, have part in the zchut, in the merit of our shiurim, Be'ezrat Hashem. Now we come to the halacha tet, the ninth halacha. Afilu aviv rasha ubal averot mechabdo mitere mimenu. Even if your father is wicked and is a sinner, you are still obligated to honor him, because through the father and mother you came to this world. So you're still obligated to honor him. Vafilu mamzer, even if a person is a bastard. Mamzer is a child that was born from a married woman that was with a man that is not her husband, and she got pregnant from that man that is not her husband. The son is called mamzer. So even a bastard is obligated to honor his father and mother. ויש אומרים דאינו מחויב לכבד אביו רשע כל זמן שלא עשה תשובה. And there are some authorities that say that that you don't have to honor your father when he is wicked and didn't do it, and he did not repent. ואח לצערו אסור, but it's forbidden to cause him any sorrow. ויש להחמיר כסברה ראשונה, but we have to be stringent and follow the first opinion that you have to honor your father and mother, even though they are not listening to Hashem and not following his way. The 10th commandment, ראה לאביו שעובר על דברי תורה. So if we saw that our father is violating the laws of the Torah, לא יאמר לו עברת על דברי תורה. We are not allowed to tell our father, father, you have sinned, you transgressed the Torah laws. You are not allowed to be straight like this, because you have to respect your father. Ela yomar lo, so rather he has to tell him, Abba, father, ktiv batorah kach vekach, it's written in the Torah this and this. Ki'ilu shoel mimenu, it's like you are, as though you are asking from him, you know, I saw in the Torah that it's written this and this, like you're asking from your father, ולא כמזירו, and not like you are, I'm trying to find the right word, מזהיר, איך אומרים מזהיר, סיגי, ברח לי מהראש עכשיו, מזהיר.
Warning,
yes. Not like you are warning him and you're strict with him. No, it's like you're asking him. You know, when we do things in a nice way and with a loving heart, then the energy that we have inside us goes into the heart of another person, and then he's willing to listen to us. And especially if it's the father and mother. So it's not like you're warning him, but like you're asking him. ואב יבין מעצמו ולא יתבייש. So the father will realize what he needs to do, and he won't be humiliated by our words. The next halacha, אמר לו אביו לעבור על דברי תורה. If your father tells you to transgress, to sin, and go over the words of the Torah, the laws of the Torah, בין על מצוות עשה, בין על מצוות לא תעשה, even if it's a positive commandment or prohibition commandment, אפילו על מצווה של דבריהם, even if it's a rabbinical prohibition, לא ישמע לו. You're not allowed to listen to your father if he tells you to go over the Torah, to violate the Torah commandments, or even the our sages, the rabbinical commandments. Why? Because it says in פרשת קדושים, חומש ויקרא, chapter 19, verse 3, it says, איש אמו ואביו תיראו. So we are obligated to fear our mother and father. ואת שבתותי תשמורי, and we are obligated to preserve the Shabbat. אני השם אלוקיכם, I am Hashem your God. Which means, Hashem put in the same verse, in the same pasuk, Shabbat and that we are obligated to reserve Shabbat with the fear of father and mother. By this we know af al pi shezarticha al morab avim, even though I'm warning you that you will have the fear of your father and mother. Im amar lecha chalel et haShabbat, if your father told you violate the Shabbat, al tishma lo, you're not allowed to listen to him. וכן בשאר כל המצוות, because Shabbat includes all, he or she that keeps the Shabbat, it's like he kept all of the commandments. So this is parallel to all of the commandments that God gave him. Why? That God gave us. אני השם אלוקיכם. I am Hashem, your God. All of us are obligated to God. All of us. אתה ואביך חייבים בכבודי. You and your father, both of the, you and your father, both of you are bound to honor God. לפיכך לא תשמע לו לבטל את דבריי, so therefore you are not allowed to disregard my words, God says, and you have to follow what Hashem says. וגם מצוות דרבנן, and the addition is for the rabbinical commandments, you remember we have 613 commandments by the Torah, 7 commandments by our sages. Together 620, the numerical value of a crown in Hebrew, Keter. וגם מצוות דרבנן, דברי השם יתברך שמוהן, and also all of the rabbinical commandments are the words of Hashem, literally. דכתיב לא תסור. So we see over here, we're going, this Shabbat is Shabbat Shoftim. And it says in Shoftim, the portion of Shoftim, chapter 17, verse 11, it's af al pi, lo, al pi ha-Torah asher yurucha, which means when the rabbis tell you, when the chachamim, when the mori tells you, asher yurucha tells you, ve'al mishpat asher yomru lecha, and also regarding a commandment that they will tell you. Just I'm going to open it because I want to give you all of the mishpat to know what happens if we don't listen. So it's chapter 17. Okay. It's chapter 17 and it says al pi haTorah asher yorucha, so according to the teaching that they will teach you, ve'al haMishpat, and according to the judgment asher yomru lecha, that they will say to you, lo tasur min hadavar asher yigidu lecha yamin u'smol. You are not allowed not listen to them, but you need to follow and then go left or right, but you have to follow exactly what they told you, the rabbis, the chachamim, the mori. ואיש אשר יעשה בזדון לבלתי שמוע אל הכהן העומד לשרת שם את השם אלוקיך, and he who will on purpose will not listen to the kohen, which is today it's the rabbi or the chacham or the mori, העומד לשרת שם את השם אלוקיך, that serves Hashem your God, או אל השופט or to the דיין, ומת האיש ההוא בארת הרע מישראל. So this person has a judgment of death, and you should take and destroy any evil from the children of Israel. This is how much it's harsh. So we need to listen to the commandments of Hashem and also to the commandments that our sages gave us. And another thing, amar lo aviv, and if your father told you shelo yedaber im ploni, that you're not allowed to speak with a certain person, veshelo imchalo, and you're not allowed to forgive him, veben haya rotze leitpayes, but the son wanted to reconcile, ein lo lachush lefkudat aviv, so you can reconcile and not listen to the order of your father. He asul lisno shum yehudi, because we are not allowed to hate any Jew. And it says in Parashat Kedoshim, Chumash Vayikra, it says over there, chapter 19, verse 17, lo tisna et achicha bilbavcha, hochech tochech et amitecha, velo tisa alav chet. You are not allowed to hate your fellow human being in your heart, and you will not, and you have to rebuke him if you see something wrong, in a nice way, in the right way. We spoke about it, and rebuking if he won't listen to you, you go privately to a person that you know that he will listen to him, and you ask him to do that anonymously. And בסייעתא דשמיא, and furthermore, it's written, לא תיקום ולא תיטור, ואהבת את רעך כמוך, אני השם. You are not allowed. It's also פרשת קדושים. The next verse, you're not allowed to revenge. You are not allowed to have a grudge. You should love your fellow human being. I am Hashem. So, this is a commandment from Hashem, כי אסור לשנוא שום יהודי. You are forbidden to hate any Jew. אם לא כשראו שהוא עובר עבירה, unless you see that he committed a sin, ונמצא שאב ציבה הוא לעבור על דברי תורה, but before I want to explain this, you are not allowed to hate any Jew. Even if you see him do a sin, you can hate his action, but you love his soul, because the soul is from God. And nobody sins unless a foolish spirit comes into them. Yisrael HaChamim says a beautiful thing about this. It's written at the beginning of Shoftim Veshotrim. This is the portion of this Shabbat. This coming Shabbos Bezat Hashem, it's Parashat Shoftim. And it says, Shoftim Veshotrim titen lecha bechol sha'arecha. So Shoftim is judges, Shotrim is officers. And if you write the words in Hebrew, if you look at it, and you take the pay from Shoftim, and you take the resh from Shotrim, you take it out of the words, what you have after that is Shotim, foolish, from both of them. Which means a person doesn't sin unless a foolish spirit comes into him. Why? Because we all know God, but we are dressed up with a clothing of a body. And what happens is that it confuses us. We have the good inclination, the evil inclination. And if we are not looking at this world with a spiritual eyes, because we see the world with a physical eyes, but if we don't look at the world with spiritual eyes, then we miss the goal in this world. And then we behave like foolish and we listen to the evil inclination. The evil inclination is an angel. He knows his master. He knows the Lord. He knows God. He is just doing what God told him to do, to test us, in order that we will fight him. And then when he tests us and we fight him and we listen to God, then he has the merit to go and say a song in front of God. But that's his job. And this is in order that we will have the merit to go back under the throne of God. So, we are not allowed to hate anyone, but we're not allowed to hate any Jew, but dear ladies, we can dislike the action of the person, but we love his soul, because the soul is pure. So if your father tells you not to to speak to a person and not to forgive him, and you want to reconcile, then what your father is asking you is against the Torah. And then you don't listen to him about that. You're not allowed to follow what he tells you, what he orders you. Now, dear ladies, we are going to go to Ilchot Shabbat. So, Bezrat Hashem, you remember that when we are speaking about the hides, ma'abed, processing or tanning skins, so now we're going to speak about processing food. We started last lesson, we're going to speak about processing food. And you remember I told you that I saw skin hide. Well, the difference is that the skin is from small animals like goats, sheep, and deer. And the hide is from large animals like cows. So the melacha of me'abed, processing and or tanning a skin, applies to skin and hide. However, Rashi says in his commentaries he says that the malacha also applies to preserving food. Why? Because there's part of the process is putting skin in lime or in salt, like you see over here, okay, lime and salt, and you put the skin. We also saw pictures of the skin last time. So this is part of the processing. So a salting a raw a meat or raw vegetables or raw I won't speak now about the vegetables, the meat, raw meat, raw fish, or off, and chicken. So it's also part of me'abed because it's similar to processing the skin or the hide. Okay, so let's continue now. We'll speak. So Rashi says, so preserving food is also part, even though it's not the same because this is food, but still it's similar to the process of me'abed, of to processing the skin or the hide, then it's a part of it, processing food. The Rambam says, he says that there's no Torah or rabbinical prohibition for me'abed of processing regarding food, but it is forbidden because it's considered mevashel, cooking. So anyway, it's forbidden. Rashi says it's forbidden because it's similar to me'abed. Rambam says it's forbidden because it's similar to cooking. Okay, when you put oil, because it absorbs all of the ooze of the food outside. So this is preserving. And what is beautiful, the Mishnah Brura, the Chafetz Chaim says about this, that he rules it's forbidden to salt several pieces of food together, because of the prohibition of both of them, of me'abed and cooking. And the Rambam says, how is it similar to cooking? So it's, the Rambam says it's not a prohibition by me'abed. It's not a prohibition by me'abed, but it's prohibition of cooking because it's preserving. Kovesh be'ivrit. It's preserving. So salting vegetables that are commonly preserved, that is, usually we preserve them, is prohibited because it's similar to me'abed. Furthermore, salting vegetables that are not commonly preserved, but they are done in a way that it's obvious that that it's similar to preserving, which means we put the salt, it's Shabbat, we put the salt, and we didn't eat it immediately, and we are waiting with it. So it's like the salt is absorbing the ooze of the food, of the vegetables. So it's prohibited because it's like kovesh. It's like preserving, it's like cooking. So preserving vegetables on Shabbat, here I'm showing you a picture. Preserving vegetables on Shabbat is prohibited. This is pickling. So let's go to salting several pieces of vegetables together. So there are a few things and we'll do it together. It is forbidden to salt, like we said, together several pieces of radish, kohlrabi, or any other type of vegetable that is commonly preserved because it appears it is similar to preserving, because it's kovesh. However, it is permissible to do that. It is to put salt on them, even if they are together. It's permissible if we add oil or vinegar to them or lemon juice immediately. If we pour it on them, because these liquids, they absorb, they dilute the strength of the salt, and by diluting the strength of the salt, there's no preserving. So it doesn't matter, and it doesn't matter the order of putting the oil, the vinegar, or the lemon juice. You can put it before you put the salt or after you put the salt on it, and you're eating it immediately in the meal, so it doesn't look like preserving, okay? So I'm showing you over here. This is the radishes, okay? You see over here. This is the book, Shabbat B'Tifarta. So this is the radishes, you see over here. So you're not allowed to put the salt on them unless you put oil or vinegar or lemon juice on it. then if it's added, then it takes, it dilutes the strength of the salt, and therefore it's not, it doesn't look like preserving, it's not similar to preserving. So what happens with fruits and vegetables that are not normally preserved? So it's permissible to salt fruits or vegetables that are not normally preserved, but the Mishnah Berura says another thing, and I'm giving you so you'll have all, Bezrat Hashem, what I can, that you'll have a perspective for everything, and if you have a question, please consult a rabbi and ask him. So the Mishnah Berura quotes the Pri Megadim, and he says this: the salt should not be spread in a way that appears that it's being done for preservation for a long time until a natural juice is oozed out of it. This is forbidden with fruits and vegetables that are even not commonly preserved. Okay, like it says, it says the same thing about Shulchan Aruch in Shemaran Yosef Karo. Furthermore, it is permissible to dip several pieces of radishes in kohlrabi. I don't know why I have a problem with this word, kohlrabi, in salt in order to eat them one after the other. This is permissible, but it's forbidden to leave them for a long time again because it's similar to preserving, because then the salt will ooze out the juice from them and it's similar to preserving. If you dip them with salt, just take a care that they won't be one next to the other. The pieces that you're taking will not touch each other, and then it's permissible. Salting meat and eggs. It's permissible to add salt to meat and eggs that are already cooked, if one intends to eat them immediately. It is forbidden if one intends to eat them the following day, of course, because it's preservation. And it's also, some of the Paskim say it's permissible if there is no intention of preserving them, and it is necessary for him to in order to eat them. But because it's similar to the process of preservation, so if you put salt on it, see that you eat it immediately. Okay, like over here in the picture that you put salt on the meat, see that you eat it immediately, then you don't fall in between the chairs. Salting the shredded cabbage. So in our days it's also common to preserve shredded cabbage. So salting shredded cabbage is permissible only if we add oil or vinegar or lemon juice on it, okay? That dilutes the power of the salt. Because when we add the oil and the lemon juice, it's obvious that we are not doing it we didn't put the salt to preserve the cabbage, because today it's common to preserve cabbage. Furthermore, adding salt to a vegetable salad. Okay, it is permissible to add salt to tomato, cucumbers, as a vegetable salad, even though we don't add the vinegar oil, because these are not the salad that we make from cucumbers and tomato is not for preservation. It's not normally preserved. But however, it is forbidden to salt the salad now to be eaten later, because again it oozes all of the juice out and it looks like preservation. Okay, this we said, let's see. The Mishnah Berura says about this also, it quotes the Pri Megadim. He says like this: it is permissible to salt vegetables that are not commonly preserved. Accordingly, it is permissible to salt vegetables even if they are commonly preserved, if they are cut into a form that is not commonly used when preserving them. Now, salting preserved vegetables. It is permissible to salt fully preserved vegetables, for example, pickled vegetables, okay, if they are fully already preserved. So even if I took a fully preserved vegetable, a pickle, I took him out, but it was already fully preserved, and I ate and I want to put it back, I can put it back because it was fully preserved. But it is forbidden to sell vegetables that are not fully preserved, and of course we can't put them back because it's similar to processing. Salting shredded radish. Oh, and another thing I'm reminding you, that that even if it's we took out a vegetable that is not fully preserved, we put salt on it, and we put again olive oils, sorry, oil or vinegar or lemon juice. Then it's okay. We allow to eat it, and it's okay. It's permissible because then it's not for preserving. It's for eating immediately. It is forbidden to salt the grated the radishes because this is the way they are preserved, although radishes are not preserved sometimes in this manner. But Rav Shlomo Shlomo Zalman Oirbach, Alav Shlomo Zrutot Hagan Eleinu, he says the Gemara says that radishes should not be salted. So because the Gemara says radishes should not be salted, one must refrain from salting them. So radishes, Bezrat Hashem, see that you don't that we don't salt them. This is radishes, tznon in Hebrew. So usually don't preserve it like this, you preserve it by cutting it to pieces. So this is not the way you preserve it usually. But Rabbi Shlomo Zalman Auerbach, Zchutot Hagan Eleinu, says that the Gemara said that you should not salt grated radishes, so we should refrain from doing this. And like we said before, if one removes a vegetable from a pickled jar and realizes that it is not fully pickled, it is forbidden to put it back into the jar since it will cause it to become fully pickled. But one, if we took, like we said before, but if we took a vegetable, or here we have over here olives, okay, so if we took it and it's already fully pickled, so we are allowed to put it back, okay, if it's already fully pickled. Okay, banot yekarot, so we finished now with the melacha of Me'abed, and Bezrat Hashem, the next time we are on the 29th melacha. I'm very excited, right? Which is memachek, and v'siyata dishmeya, it's smoothing. This is the next melacha, and thank you Hashem. And now we are going to continue with shmirat halashon, regarding our tongue. We're going to the Chafetz Chaim. So we are in the month of Rachamim v'Slichot, the month of Elul, that is Ani le'dodi v'dodi li. I'm to my beloved and my beloved to me. I want to say something about salting, which is part of Me'abed. So dear ladies, usually the people that light a candle on Tuesday for Rabbi Menachem Mendel Rimanov, Ben Yosef, and light a candle for him, put tzedakah for him, and ask that he will save the children of Israel and each of us as a whole, and as a whole people, and individually, b'siyata dishmeya. And Rabbi Menachem Mendel Merimanov, Ben Yosef, he was born at the end of the 18th century, lived at the beginning of the 19th century, and he used to say, and it's mamash connected to salting now, he wanted Hashem to help the children of Israel. So I'm saying this in his name and our times. He used to say, "Va'yaki timatzena oto ra'ot rabot v'tzarot." So when the children of Israel are confronted with so many challenging, evil challenges, wicked people that come on the children of Israel, this is a pasuk, this is a verse from פרשת וילך, from the portion of וילך at almost the end of חומש דברים, chapter 31 verse 21. So he used to pick up his hands to heaven and he used to call Hashem and tell him, ריבונו של עולם, the Lord of the world, אל תמלח יותר מדי, don't put too much salt. Salt means yesurim, suffering. Don't put too much salt. En yadu alecha, because you know, ki yoter midai melach mekalkel et habasar. Too much salt ruins the meat. When you want to kosher the meat and you put too much salt, it can ruin the meat. Ve'yoter midai yesurim lo yetivu otanu. And too many sufferings that you put on us will not make us better. רחם נא איפה על עמך ישראל, please have mercy upon the children of Israel, ואל תמלח יתר על המידה, and don't salt, which means being suffering more than supposed to be. So with this word, may Hashem help us, and he will reveal the king. We want the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of King David, and the building of the third temple. במהרה בימינו אמן. So dear ladies, now we go, I need this too, we're going to learn from Chafetz Chaim, and I need Parashat Beit Hanan, okay, I need Parashat Beit Hanan, and I'm taking also going to learn from Ahavat Chaim, Rabbi Menachem Menashe Alav Shalom Zkutot Agen Aleinu, and also from Chovat HaLevavot, משער הביטחון, חובת הלבבות. Not שער הביטחון, but the sixth gate, which is the gate of surrendering to Hashem. So we're going to learn from both of these two, בעזרת השם, because we are in the month, אני לדודי ודודי לי, I'm to my beloved, and my beloved to me, הרואה בשושנים, the shepherds, the roses, dear ladies, בסייעתא דשמיא, it means, this is from the Song of Songs, שיר השירים that King Solomon wrote, אני is the Knesset Israel, is the children of Israel, ודודי, my uncle, my beloved, is Hashem, is God. So we need to, this is the time to that we will wake ourselves up, אור ישנים, when there's התערותא דלתתא, when there's an awakening here in this world, of us human beings, of us Jews, there's also awakening in heaven, and in order to close all the prosecutors, all of the angels that are prosecuting us in heaven, because nothing happens in here before it starts in heaven, in order to close them out, we need to do tshuva, we need to repent. So dear ladies, we are now coming, we are in Halacha 20, איך לעשות תשובה על עוון לשון הרע, we are in the second chapter, Halacha 20. How do we do tshuva? How do we repent for speaking, for slandering, for speaking Lashon Hara? Lashon Hara is slandering. So if I use it in Hebrew, you'll know. Bezrat Hashem. And remember, Lashon Hara is about things that are true that we say in order to belittle another person and to humiliate him. God forbid, anything that we don't want others to do to us, we shouldn't do to others. And this is only from the evil inclination that wants to separate and conquer, Fred Umshol, the good inclination. God wants us to be united and to love each other and to see the beautiful things in each other. And by this, when we say good things about each other, then we elevate the soul of each other. That's the purpose of the world. That's why we came. Nobody stays here. We came in, we go out. It's a temporary world, all this. It's only imaginary that we have power. The power is God's power. It's not our power. Hashem bestows upon us His blessings so we can do His will and not go against His will. And His will that we will love His children. That's the will of God. And we'll love all of the creation. Then there won't be any problem of climate warming, nothing. Everything will be good. All of the spiritual actions that we do, everything that we do, physical and spiritual, influences the whole world. No one can influence the world except us. So we need to love each other. עשוי צזר והיא מי שנכשל בלשון הרע וחפץ לעשות תשובה, היא הוא. He who sinned and spoke lashon hara, slandering, and he wants to repent, and we should repent. Talui hadavar b'midat ha'ashpa'a shehu lidivrei ha'gnai shedibar. So it's the repentance depends also how the way of repentance depends on how much it influenced the person that we spoke of. Okay, when we wanted to belittle him and to humiliate him. Im shomea lo emin lesipuro, if now a person slandered a person in front of another person, and the person that listened does not believe to anything that he said, and so vedivrei agnai lo pagu bichvod ha'ish alav diber, and the slandering that the person spoke about another person, the person that listened didn't believe anything that he said, and this did not hurt the honor or disgrace the honor of the person that was spoken of. Nechshavim advarim la'avon sheben adam lamakom. So then the sin is considered between God and us. Just like we had with Miriam. Sof parashat, at the end of parashat Ba'alot Chai in Chumash Bamidbar, we see that Miriam sees Tzipora, the wife of Moshe Rabbeinu. I'm going to go to parashat Ba'alot Chai, the end of parashat Ba'alot Chai. And over there, we see that Miriam, the prophet, Miriam, the sister of Moshe Rabbeinu and Aaron HaKohen, the three of them were the providers of the children of Israel. And Miriam brought the well of Miriam, Aaron HaKohen, the clouds of glory, and Moshe Rabbeinu, Haman, the food that came from heaven. And we see that Miriam sees Tzipora and that she doesn't make herself pretty for her husband. And she said, what happened? And she said, well, my husband doesn't come to me because he speaks with Hashem all the time. So, and she comes to Aaron, Miriam, and she wants that Moshe Rabbeinu will have a regular relationship with his wife. She didn't mean, God forbid, to speak bad about her brother Moshe. She just referred it to Aaron HaKohen. And the only one that heard this, because Hashem hears all of our conversation. There's an eye that sees, an ear that listens, and all our actions are written in a book. Actions between our thoughts are not known. It's known only for Hashem. Hashem knows all of our thoughts. And He speaks with us, also with our thoughts. But how do our thoughts come to action? By speech. So our thoughts by speech come to action because the ear hears, and by the ear, which is a microphone to all of the organs of the body, all of the body hears, and from this we come to action. So dear ladies, it says over here that she spoke to Aaron. She didn't say nothing to Moshe, but she spoke privately to her brother Aaron. Immediately Hashem calls all of them to the tent of meeting, the holy tent. Vayomer Hashem pit'om, immediately, suddenly, el Moshe vel Aaron vel Miriam tz'u shloshtechem el ohel moed ve'yatzu shloshtam. And Hashem descends, and so suddenly Hashem tells them to come, the three brothers, Aaron, Miriam and Moshe, to the tent of meeting, and Hashem descends with a cloud upon the entrance of the tent. And over there He rebukes Miriam, which means this is a sin between a person and God. And He puts leprosy immediately on her. And for 7 days she's out of the three camps. The camp of Shechina, the camp which is the camp of Divine Presence, the camp of the Levites, and the camp of the Israelites. She's outside. And it isn't even considered for us in nowadays that she spoke a lashon hara, that she slandered. Can you imagine how harsh it is? We have to think before we speak. So what do? If you see something, you ask from Hashem for help. Hashem, please help this couple, that there will be peace among them. It's ממש, you have to be careful with what we say. It says in אהבת חיים, שרבים מנחם מנשה עליו שעושה אותו נגן אלינו, in פרשת בית חנן, he says over here, when Hashem tells Moshe Rabbeinu, רב לך, אל תעסק דבר אליי, stop, he says, don't continue davening, praying to me. But it says in the Zohar HaKadosh, שלכל אדם הוא קצב לו כמה מילים לדבר במשך כל חייו. A person, when he comes to this world, every baby that comes to this world, he has a limited amount of words to speak in this world. Which means when we finish this amount of words that we receive from God, then we pass from this world. What kind of words? Words for our livelihood. King Solomon says in the Song of Songs, Shir HaShirim, Nafshi Yatza Bedabro, my soul went out with a speech. So when we speak about our livelihood, we have a certain amount of words that we received before we came to this world. When we were born, this and this is the amount of words that we are allowed to say. Should we waste it on slandering, gossiping, saying lies? It shortens our life. The unlimited words that we can say, the Zohar HaKadosh says, is words of holiness. Words of Torah, Shir HaShirim, Perek Shira, words of charity with our mouth. When we speak good to other people, elevate their soul, help them, speak words of emuna, of faith, of bitachon, of confidence. This is unlimited. Speaking about Hashem, speaking about God, this is unlimited. But for our livelihood, it's limited. So we choose, this is a freedom of choice, either to slander and say lies or gossip about people. We are shortening our lives with it's our own doing. Can you imagine? So he says, מובא בזוהר שלכל אדם הוא קצב לו כמה מילים לדבר במשך כל ימי חייו. So everybody comes with a limited amount of words for his whole life. וכשהוא מרבה לדבר מקרב מיתתו. And when he speaks a lot, his death is near. חוץ מדברי תורה, which means he speaks a lot for his livelihood, or slandering, gossiping, lying. חוץ מדבר, except for the words of Torah, שמרבה חיים, this prolongs our life. ולכן אמר קהלת, so קהלת, which is King Solomon, wrote in the book of קהלת, אל תהי כסיל, don't be a fool. למה תמות בלא איתך? Why should you pass away before your time? Because you already finished all of the amount of words for your livelihood. כי הכסיל מרבה דברים ויצטרך למות קודם זמנו. Because the person who is foolish will speak too much and fall with slandering and gossiping and leshona and lying, and by this he will die before his time. Furthermore, when a person says leshonara, three people die from this, because leshonara, slandering, it is parallel to three averot. This is Masechet Arachin, page 15 and 16 over there, but Gemara, it says that slandering is parallel to three sins, that it says that you shouldn't violate them, you shouldn't do them, you should die not do them. Which one of the three are worshipping other gods, having intimate relationship that is forbidden, and killing. Slandering does these three things. Three people die by slandering. The one that said, that is speaking, the one that is hearing, and the one that is spoken of. The one that, and immediately when a person speaks about another person, our books are open in heaven. It's like Rosh Hashanah at that time. Rabbi Nachman Breslov says, בליקוטי מוהר"ן, that when you speak about another person, immediately the books are open. Your book, the book of the person that is listening, and the book, the person that is spoken of. If you are speaking, for example, women come to me and their parents are speaking to them and taking out things that bother them in their heart, so you have to have the fear of Hashem. So you make peace. You're allowed to listen, but to make peace, that they will have peace of mind and peace with other people. That is allowed, but not to make fights and to have disagreement between people. When you do it in order to, you listen to a person and you make peace and you put the person in place or you stop him from sinning, that's a good thing. But if you use this in order to separate a husband and wife, to separate a friend from another friend, this is forbidden. So it says over here in בחובת הלבבות של רבנו בחיי, it says over here the sixth gate, the gate of surrendering to Hashem. Okay, that if a person, בדבר סופר על אחד מאנשי החסד, שיזכרו ברע, that a person spoke about a righteous person, he spoke about him things that are not good, and the righteous person heard about this, אז שלח לו אותו שדיבר עליו לשון הרע, so he sent to the person who slandered him, he sent him מגש מלא מזמר, מזמרת עירו, a plate with chocolate and good things on it, וכתב לו, and he wrote to him, נודע לי אחי שאתה שרת לי מזכויותיך, it came to my attention that you gave me from your commandments that you followed and the good deeds that you did, that you gave from me. לכן ראיתי לגמול לך זה. So I wanted to give you something back, and I am giving you a plate of good things on it. What does it mean? Because when the three books are open, the one that is speaking, the one that is hearing, and the one that is spoken of, immediately the merit of the one, which means the commandments that you follow and the good deeds that you did, so you just read Tehillim, okay, so you just read Tehillim and you spoke about another person, immediately God forbid they take our good things that we did and the mitzvot that we did and they move it to the person that you spoke of, and the sins of the person that you spoke of immediately is transferred to the one that is speaking and the one that is hearing. Who is punished more? The one that is hearing, because he should prevent his friend from doing a sin, from sinning. So this person that heard that this person spoke about him and said, thank you for all of the merit that you gave me, I want to give you something back, so he gave him a plate with good things on it. וכבר אמר אחד הצדיקים, יש שיבואו רבים מבני אדם ליום הדין, so that when a person stands, so one of the righteous person says that when a person stands in front of the court of heaven, וכאשר הגישו לפניו מעשיהם, so and then you see all of your merit and the good angels that you created and the not good angels that you created, because they stand as advocates in front of the court of heaven, so the good angels are defense lawyers and not good angels are the prosecuting lawyers over there, so they see in your book זכויותיהם, זכויות שלא עשו, so they will see that they have good angels from commandments and good deeds that they didn't do, and they will ask, is this the court of heaven, this is the truth, וככה שום, we didn't do this, these are good angels, but I didn't do this. ויאמרו להם, הסאום אשר יכלו נגדכם והוציאו עליכם שם רע. But you got this, all of this merit from all of the people that slandered you, gossiped about you, and gave you a bad reputation. Can you imagine? וכן כאשר ינוקו זכויות הולכי רחיל ידרשו באותה שעה. And also a person who slandered other people and gossiped and said lies about another person, when he comes to the court of heaven, he said, well, but I did so many, I followed the commandment, I did so many good things, good deeds, where are they? And they will tell him, ויאמר להם, נוקו לכם כאשר דיברתם לשון הרע נגד פלוני ופלוני. We took out all of your merit and gave it to the person that you spoke of. וכן גם אשר הם שימצאו מקצתם בפנקס רעותיהם, רעות שלא עשו. And then you will see that he has destructive angels that he didn't create. I didn't do this, he will say. וכאשר יכחישם, when he says, I didn't create these destructive angels, יאמרו להם, these are from the person that you spoke of. You got all of his sins. Is that worth? That's worthwhile for us? We work so hard to say Tehillim, to concentrate, to say Perek Shira, Shir HaShirim, to daven, to pray, and to speak to Hashem. This is a prayer by the Torah. And in a split of a second, we lost everything. And the judgment is just judgment in heaven. Here everything is politics, but not in heaven. So dear ladies, we are warned not to do this. So it says, so if we didn't humiliate and we didn't hurt and disgrace the honor of that person that we spoke of, the sin is sin, but between us and God. And this is the sin that had Miriam. Nobody heard her except Hashem. Even Moshe Rabbeinu didn't know that she spoke about him. And she didn't mean to say something that is not good. She just wanted to help her brother Moshe. She's the one that was that took care of him. She's the one that when he was on the Nile, she was the one that was looking after him. She was the one that went to the daughter of Pharaoh, Batia, to tell her, I have a woman that can breastfeed him. She is the one that came to her father before Moshe Rabbeinu was born and told him, Abba, Paro decreed about the boys, all of the sons, but you decreed about sons and daughters, boys and girls, when you divorced your wife. She was very righteous. And immediately Hashem gave tzaraat on her, leprosy. Today the tzaraat is not on the body, the tzaraat is on the soul. When we sin with slandering and gossiping and saying lies about others, and today it's all over the media, and this reproduces toladot, derivatives, which means if a person slanders online another person, then it doesn't stop now on the time that he slandered, because everybody that will look, even after a day, after a week, after an hour, after a year, 2 years, 3 years, this is a sin that continues, that has derivatives for years. So we are going to, God forbid, be punished for this forever, because it's online. Not only, and can you imagine? זה אבון שמביא תולדות. So how do we repent for this when it's considered that it's a sin between us and God? So it's like במקרה כזה דרך התשובה היא כמו בכל אבון שבן אדם למקום. In this case, the way of repentance is the way of repentance that we learn between us and God everywhere, which is first to recognize that we did a sin, because some people don't pray. It became a habit, it became part of them, because when you practice a thing a few times, a good thing or not a good thing, then it becomes part of you, second nature. So people don't even pay attention that they are doing it. And the person that we spoke of, there's a prejudice against him already, even if you don't know him. So first of all, to recognize your sin. The second thing is charata, charata la'avar. We need to regret, okay, what we did. להתחרט בכנות וברצינות על החטא שעשינו. חטאנו, אבינו, פשענו. We really regret what we did. Hashem, please help us. We don't remember everything that we did before and whom we spoke of. Please help us to fix it. So we regret it. The third thing is bidui dvarim. Bidui dvarim means that we confess. We confess in front of Hashem, until in חטאתי אביתי פשעתי, I've sinned. חטאנו אבינו פשענו, we have sinned with the words and we spoke about this and this person. Hashem, remind me all of the people that I spoke of, please let me do a tshuva to repent about it. Let me fix it. בסייעתא דשמיא, because it's very hard to fix this. So slandering, gossiping and saying lies about people because it spreads like feathers in the wind. It's very hard to collect when a person asked, how do I do tshuva? He asked the rabbi, how do I do tshuva about slandering? He said, bring me a pillow with feathers. So he brought them a pillow with feathers, and then he went with him to the roof, and he took a knife and he tore the pillow, and he let the feathers with the wind go everywhere. And now he went down again with the person and told him, now go and collect all of the feathers. The person told him, I don't even know where it went to. So he told him, this is slandering and gossiping and saying lies, because it's like a chain, you don't know where it goes to. Who is the next person that will listen? It's very hard to do tshuva on it, but we do our effort in this world, and we'll speak about it. What happens with things that is so hard to do tshuva? How does Hashem help us to repent over this when we are true and our mouth and our hearts are even? So bidui dvarim, and it's very important in our mouth to say what we did. Hashem anyway knows everything. There's an eye that sees and ear that listens, and all of our actions are written in a book. So Hashem anyway knows everything that we did. So, and when we speak, because we ruined the written commandments in the Torah by speaking Lashon Hara, by slandering, gossiping and saying lies, we need to fix it. The fixing is by admitting it in our mouth. And the third thing is Kabbalah La'atid. The fourth thing is Kabbalah La'atid, that we accept in the future that we'll never repeat it. And know that when we accept upon ourselves not to repeat the sin, the evil inclination will come and test us. So we have to be strong. We ask from Hashem for strength, Bezat Hashem. עליו להחליט ולקבל על עצמו בלב שלם כי להבא לא יעשיכם. So we have to accept upon ourselves that we will never repeat what we did, בסייעתא דשמיא, that Hashem will give us the strength to do that. Dear ladies, with this I would like to bless all of us, that we will all have the zechut to greet Mashiach Tzidkenu ברחמים מועיל במהרה בימינו אמן, אל יום נא וזכור לטוב, לעולם ייפרד אדם מחברו בדבר הלכה יחיד ברבים הלכה כרבים. אחינו כל בית ישראל הנתונים בצרה ובשביעה, עומדים בין בים ובין ביבשה, המקום ירחם עליהם ויוצא מצרה לרווחה ומאפלה לאורה ושיבוד לגאולה, השתא בעגלה בזמן קריב אמרו אמן. שבת שלום ואורך, good Shabbos to everyone, good news בעזרת השם, to us and Klal Israel.